Hello, Eagles. My name is Jack Moran.
And my name is Nathan Stedman, and this is your Granite Hills News Network.
Attention all students, our student body selected this year's Golden Apple Award winner. The Golden Apple Award recognizes the awards of a teacher that has made a grand impact on their students, inside and outside the classroom. And Golden Apple Award winner is...
So first of all, the thing that makes the Golden Apple such a really special thing is it's student selected. Student nominated, student voted, student selected. So they picked you, Tarbeck. They picked a teacher that has some of the highest academic standards for her kids, hands down, but will carry them on her back, cares about them, passionately wants to make every kid in her class love math. And I've witnessed that kid that has said, I'm not good enough, I can do math, all of a sudden be a stellar math student. The purpose of the Golden Apple Award is to recognize outstanding classroom teacher and the selection process that I went through. The students select and pick that person. The number one qualifying factor is has a good, sound knowledge of the subject matter. Yes?
Yes.
Yes. Makes the subject or class interesting and keeps the students' attention. Yes. Has good discipline and classroom control. And the key, but the key thing about that one is that kids could have what people would observe and say, oh, look, her class is quiet and people are sitting there and whatever. But it's not. It's kids are engaged and they have respect and appreciation for the person leading them through the lessons. And you see that when you walk in the room and when you talk to the students that have had you. Likes her job and the students and relates well with them.
Check.
Demonstrates concern for students and is a caring person. Helps students learn by trying different approaches or methods. You're pretty creative, and I love that because you know one size doesn't fit all. Has a good sense of humor. Is a good role model and sets a good example. Practices what she preaches, and no one, you exemplify them. And everyone here is very proud. Is willing to put in extra time and effort to students to help them learn. Pre-pandemic, during pandemic, hands down is here for kids every hour of the day and night. And you demonstrate enthusiasm and pride. And that is for sure. So all 10 of those characteristics for sure. You exemplify them in this part of it, and we're so proud of the good picture. And the final thing that I was thinking about this morning was that everyone knows that you love kids. She is a great role model. She stands for really powerful, really good things, and she's a good person at her heart. And I would think that if Pink is looking for a role model and a superstar in their field, as she is in hers, Belinda Pargo, that would be you. Thank you. So congratulations.
Hello, Eagles. My name is Dina Hurt, and I am the Medical Pathway Coordinator here at Granite Hills High School. You're getting ready to choose your program, so I wanted to give you some information on the medical pathway before you do this. Are you interested in a career in the medical field? Some of you already know you want to become doctors or nurses. What about a pharmacist or a pediatrician? How about a veterinarian or an emergency medical technician? All of these would be wonderful careers, and they all fall within the medical field. So if you're interested in any career that falls in that field, then the medical pathway may be for you. But if you're not for certain, but you enjoy science and maybe even like helping people, then the medical pathway may still be for you. Here at Granite, our medical pathway is a four-year program taught at the honors level, and that means you can earn a weighted GPA. And of course, there's an emphasis on medicine aspect. This is again a four-year course, meaning 4 years of science. This will allow you to meet all A through G requirements for science, along with the UC requirements for science. So if you're sitting third quarter in your biology class or getting ready to sit fourth quarter in your biology class, you're almost a quarter of the way done with your first course in the Med Pathway program. Might as well hop on board then, right? Your second or sophomore year is medical chemistry with Mr. Williams. And then your third year, your junior year, you come back and see me in year one IV biology with an emphasis in anatomy and physiology. And lastly, you wrap up your medical pathway, your senior year, with Mr. Casey in your second year of IV biology. 4 years of science, I know. It may seem like a lot to some of you. Others, you're ready to sign up. But we give you a little bit of stuff like this. We like to bring in guest speakers. These are people from the medical field who work in the medical field. They share their stories on how they got to where they are, interesting cases that they got to see. They like to bring videos in. But I've even had students network and get job shadows from some of these guest speakers, all in hopes to inspire you to help you find a path through all of these different careers that can be found in the medical field. We get to take field trips so you can learn about different programs once you leave high school and you go into college about how to get into nursing careers or in medical schools, along with labs. We like to go visit those. And I like to go to the blood bank where you get to be blood typed. Internships. These are the things that you guys like to compete for. So these are exciting things for people who are very interested in a field, in the field of medicine, because they actually get to step into medical facilities and see how they work. In the HESI internship that happens during the summer at Grossmont Hospital, students actually get to visit the different departments and see what all they do. We have the Borrego Spring internship in the spring, where students actually get to work under nurses and learn how to take patient histories and help with patient care. You also get the opportunity to earn your CPR certification. So, great little resume builder and a nice thing to have. My favorite thing though, is I get to expose you all to medical style labs in the classroom. Whether you're modeling parts of a cell, looking through microscopes at human tissue, suturing up an injured banana, or performing dissections with me. This is some of my favorite parts because you get to experience science in a hands-on way. Now, I can't mention the medical pathway without talking about these completer statuses that a lot of you have heard about either through siblings or other people you know that have gone through the programs in our school or others. This is actually done by the district, but there's certain requirements. First, you're all a completer as long as you earn a 2.0 to a 2.99 and do 40 hours worth of community service within the 4 years you're here at Granite. You can jump up to silver completer if you add an 8-hour job shadow and join one session of the medical book study, and your GPA is a 3.0 to a 3.49. And lastly, the coveted gold completer status. This one includes an internship and a CPR certification, and your GPA would have to rise up to a 3.5 or higher. I'm always amazed at how many students are actually achieve this. It is such an amazing feat to me. Good job, you guys. So if this sounds interesting to you, then please apply. Go ahead, fill out the Google form that can be found at this link, or just use the QR code below. If you have any questions, please feel free to email me at dhirt@guhsd.net. That's dhirt@guhsd.net with any questions. I'm also in room 180. Applications are open from February 8th to 22nd, and I will post QR codes in all biology classrooms. I hope to hear from you soon. Have a great day, Eagles.
Hello, I'm Mr. George. I am the photography teacher here at Granite Hills High School, and I am promoting today the photography program. It fulfills your graduation requirements for fine arts, so it's a graduation required class. and it also fulfills A through G for college students that are bound to go on to college. So it has some good attributes to it. You get to use some cool equipment, some cool cameras, GoPros, Canon EOS cameras. You get to leave the classroom and go walk around campus and take pictures of different subjects. It's a fun class. If you want to be active and make some really cool projects, this is the class to take. And it does fulfill those requirements that helps you graduate. So I hope that everybody signs up for it. Sign up early because I always have a waiting list every year of students who want to take that class.
Attention 10th through 12th graders, if you have a GPA that is 3.5 or higher, please consider joining the California Scholarship Federation. CSF is now accepting applications. Please email Ms. Richards if you are interested. If you are already a member, you still must submit your grades every semester and fill out an application. And now, here is your advisory feature.
Eagles, it's February and that means it's Black History Month, so I want to go over some of the books that I have here in the library that I think you could be interested in. First, it is really important to understand Black history in association with the history of the United States. Some of these books will help you understand things like that. For instance, here's History for Beginners. Black History Month actually started as a week and it's in February to correspond with the birthdays of President Lincoln as well as Frederick Douglass. But then in the 60s, a lot with the civil rights movement, a lot of campuses and a lot of cities started celebrating it as more than just a week. Finally, in 1976, President Ford declared that it would be a Black History Month to seize the opportunity to honor the too often overlooked achievements of Black Americans throughout every endeavor in the United States. So we celebrate that today. Here is Black History for Beginners, a simple book that can help go over some of the time periods if you're interested in that. I have a lot of books that are nonfiction, for instance, Black Pioneers and Inventors, that you might be interested in. And remember, I always have memoirs and biographies and autobiographies. Something we celebrate is the first, as in the first president and first lady, and as well as the first students to desegregate high schools. One of my favorites is the first African-American ballerina to be the principal ballerina in the American Ballet Theater, as well as athletes and many athletes that you know, the Williams sisters in tennis, Tiger Woods in golf, baseball, Willie O'Ree in hockey. So if you want to read some of these books, stop by the library. Next week I'll be highlighting some of our novels.
This has been your Granite Hills News Network. Thanks for watching.
To love and be loved is to feel the sun from both sides. Have a great week, Eagles.
I know it's been tough last year, but now that the year's over and we're in 2021 with good things already happening, it's time to keep your hopes up.
Yeah.